and hopped aboard what they call a train to a country that really was number one in education. Finland is ranked at or near the top of having the best educated students in the world, which left everyone wondering, really? Finland? These are the people who gave us the air guitar championship.
Hello? Hello?
And the sports of cell phone throwing and wife carrying. These are the geniuses that cracked the code to good education? I mean, how is it that the kids in Finland are ahead of the rest of the world? So here's what happened. Back in the day, Finland's schools sucked on the level that ours suck on. When they tested the world's kids, both Finland and us were usually about the same, you know, somewhere down the list of nations. But Finland didn't like that. So they tried some new ideas, and in no time, Finland shot to the top of the world. Their students were number one. How did they do that? That was the one question I wanted an answer to, and I went straight to see the enemy's Minister of Education. Before I could say anything, she blurted out their top secret.
They do not have homework.
Wait, so you reduce the homework you give them at school?
Yes. They should have more time to be kids, to be youngsters, to enjoy the life.
How many hours of homework did you get last night?
About 10 minutes or something.
10 minutes of homework?
Yeah. Maybe 15 minutes or 20 minutes.
20 minutes, about 20 minutes. Yeah.
Well, if I would have done the homework, I think it would be like 10 minutes tops.
Usually I don't really do homework that much.
The whole term, homework, is kind of obsolete, I think. In that way...
Your homework is obsolete.
Yeah. In that way that these kids, they have a lot other things to do after school.
Like what?
Like being together, like being with a family, doing sports, like playing music, like reading.
So they have no homework. What if all they want to do is climb a tree?
They could climb a tree, yeah. They can climb a tree, then they learn how to climb a tree. But they'll end up, while climbing the tree, probably finding out about different insects, and they can come to school next day telling me about what they found.
Compared to the older kids, how many hours a day did the younger ones go to school?
Mondays, 3 hours. Tuesdays, 4 hours. It varies. It's 20 hours a week.
So they're... Oh, man. Now, does this 3 or 4 hours at school include the lunch hour?
Yes.
How are they learning anything? How are you getting anything done?
Your brain has to relax every now and then. If you just constantly work, then you stop learning. And there's no use of doing that for a longer period of time.
Finland students have the shortest school days and the shortest school years in the entire Western world. They do better by going to school less.
Yay! How many languages do you speak?
English, yeah. Swedish, Spanish.
Finnish and Swedish. Finnish, English and German.
French, German.
Finnish and English.
English, Swedish and French and Spanish.
So you were an exchange student in the U.S.?
Yeah.
When you got back here in school, what did you notice that you felt relieved about?
No more multiple choice exams.
No multiple choice exams here?
Or very few of them, if any.
Really?
All of my exams in the U.S.
How do you answer the question right if it isn't listed as one of the four choices?
You write your answer.
You have to know it, actually.
Yeah.
You actually have to know it.
Yeah.
If there was one thing I heard over and over again from the Finns, it was that America should stop teaching to a standardized test.
Get rid of those standardized tests.
National testing.
Standardized tests.
Standardized testings.
What you are teaching your students is to do well on those tests, and you're not really teaching them anything.
No, we are teaching them. We're teaching them how to flunk a test, and then a bunch of schools fail the test, and those schools are turned into charter schools, and then somebody makes a lot of money.
But school is about finding your happiness, finding a way to learn,
What makes you happy?